Oftentimes, we're interested in using arrays in VBA to create a subroutine or a user-defined array function. So in this screencast, I'm going to show you how to use VBA subroutines and functions involving arrays. So the first example, the goal is to create a sub that sums cells A1 to A8. So we have a fixed range in a fixed location. Basically, what we want to do is create a subroutine that will sum those eight numbers. And obviously, this is pretty trivial because you can just use the sum function in Excel, but we want to create a subroutine that actually outputs the sum in a message box. Let's start by making a flowchart. We start, and the first thing we're going to do is iterate. If you were actually trying to do this by yourself and tally up these eight numbers, you would start with 8, then add 4, then add 2, and so on. So that's exactly what we want to do in our flowchart. We start with our I, which is going to be our index. So we start with I equals 1. We then say I equals I plus 1. And we stop when I is greater than 8. As long as I is not greater than 8, we're going to keep summing. So we have this sum, which is going to be equal to sum plus current cell value. And then we're going to keep iterating. We're going to increment I by I plus 1. Once I finally exceeds 8, then we're going to display the sum and we are done. The code for this sub that I've named sum vector is shown here. You see that we dim n as an integer, and we're going to use n to count the number of rows in a moment. We have sum, which is the running tally of the sum. We also have I, we've dimmed I as an integer, and then we have this statement here, n equals range A1 to A8 dot rows dot count. And what this does is we have an object. The object here is range A1 to A8. Now that we know the number of rows, we can iterate from I equals 1 to n. We put in this function here where the new sum is the old sum plus range A1 A8 dot cells I1. So it's the cells I comma 1 of our object, which is the range A1 to A8. So then we keep iterating until I is greater than n, and n in this case is just going to be 8, and then we message box sum is, and then this produces a sum. So I'm going to run this by pressing F5. We get an output box that is saying sum is 37. The next thing I'm going to do is show you how we can transform this into a function. So now what we're trying to do is develop a VBA function to sum an arbitrary vector, not just 8 rows, not the same location. We have a different vector here, G2 to G11. It's not 8 values and it's not in A1 to A8. So we want to be able to create a function now, not a sub, where we can type in the sum vector of a selection, and this is going to be a vector selection. When we run this, it will actually spit out the sum of that vector. So here is the sum vector code that we just worked with, and we want to make this into a function, and we want to make it so it will work on an arbitrary range. There's a couple modifications we need to make to this code, but that is changing sub to a function. And I don't know if you noticed that, but when I push down, it actually changed the end sub automatically to end function. The next thing we have to do is create dummy variable here. So I'm going to put in data range. This is the argument to our function. We're not going to be using range A1 to A8 as our object. Instead, the object is just going to be data range, which is the argument to our function. We're going to be summing the same. The other difference here is we no longer have the range as the object. Only other thing is you never want to have a message box built into a function. So we will put sum vector. That's the output of the function is equal to sum. Back over in Excel, I can type into a cell, and you see as I write this, the IntelliSense detects that I have a user-defined function, and I'm going to select what I want to put into it, and then I press enter, and it gives us the sum of 9. The next thing we're going to do is instead of summing a vector, we're going to sum an array. So for example here, we have a 3x3 array, so we have a sub here that's going to spit out a message box with our sum. So we start out, and then we actually iterate through rows, but in each array, we actually are going to iterate through all columns. So if we have a 3x5, let's say, we're going to iterate through row 1, and then for that row, we're going to iterate through all 5 columns of that row. Then we're going to bump up to the second row, and we're going to iterate through all 5 columns of that second row, and so on. So we have this nested for loops. When we're done iterating, we can display the sum. The code for this is shown here. This is a sum array. We've dimmed the number of rows, number of columns as integers, sum as a single, I and j are also counting numbers that we're going to be iterating through. You'll see here we have number of rows equals selection.rows.count, so we're counting the number of rows in that selection. And columns, we're counting the number of columns in that selection. And then we're iterating through I, which corresponds to the number of rows, and j, which corresponds to the number of columns. And for each of those cells in that array that we're on, the new sum is the previous sum plus the current value of that cell. And then we finish this off with a message box, and we end sub. So this is my selection. I'm going to press F8, and if you look down here at the locals window, you can see I just did the number of rows, it picked it up as 3, number of columns as 3. You'll notice that at the end of every for loop, that the index actually comes out of that for loop as 1 greater than the maximum, and that's just because in VBA, it actually increments the index at the end of the loop. And we end up with a message box for the sum. I'm now going to quickly transform this into a function. And to do that, I change sub to function. And when I go down, you'll notice that the end sub automatically changes to an end function. I need to add an argument, so I'll do data range, just like I did for the vector. The object is no longer selection, it's my data range. Don't want a message box in a function, so the output is just the name of the function, and that's going to equal sum. Let's test this in Excel. I can put this range in, or I can put a named range if I want. Press Enter, and that is the sum of our array. We're going to create a VBA array function. It takes an arbitrarily selected range of cells and displays on the same spreadsheet a new array, let's just say B, whose elements represent the natural log of all numbers that are greater than 0, and adds 20 to all elements in A that are less than or equal to 0. I've already got this function built in the VBE. I've got an argument data range. And one thing we have to do here, we're actually going to be creating a new array. And so we're having a local array B and a local array A within our sub. And because we have arrays within our sub, we have to declare those arrays. So I have A as a variant, and I have B as a variant. You'll notice here that I have empty parentheses. That means we don't know the size of the array to begin with, and all the dim statements have to go at the beginning of our procedure. The first thing we do is we count the number of rows in our data range. We count the number of columns in our data range. Once we know the size, we can redim A, and we can redim B with the known size now. We're going to do a double iteration because it's an array. And during each of those iterations, we're going to first pick up a value to place into our local array A. And then we're asking ourselves a question. If A is positive, then B, that's our output array, is going to be equal to log of that number. Otherwise, we're going to add 20. And then array change, that's the name of the function, is just equal to B. So let's take a look at this over in Excel. I've already named this array A, and now what I'm going to do is highlight a 3x2 because I know that that has to be the size of my output, and I'll do Control Shift Enter. So we've done conditional, so you can actually add conditionals into user-defined functions, and in this case, a user-defined array function.